The subtitle of the 2015 festival is building on 10 inspiring years. And that word inspiring, of course, is very, very important to us. One of the privileges of my role is that I get to see some of the wonderful inspiring work that goes on around the university. And in fact, this week I was introduced to something new, and that was the 3-minute thesis, where PhD students present their thesis in 3 minutes. And I have to say, it was absolutely fantastic. So I immediately thought, why don't we create the 3-minute prof? We'll get our profs. It'll be more of a challenge, but we'll get our profs presenting in 3 minutes. I think that would help inspire some of our potential future students. The eyes, of course, are all a key part of our strategy map, and inspiring our students to attain the highest academic and professional standards is key to what we do. To inspire our students to enjoy an outstanding university experience and to inspire employable and enterprising graduates. And of course, on the latter, we do very well nationally from a national stance. We've set ourselves a specific target to be in the top 10, and I'm very keen that we actually achieve that. And where does all this inspiration come from? Well, it comes from the people in this room, working in partnership, of course, with our colleagues in the Student Union. And I think that's one thing that wonderfully characterises our university, the great partnership that exists between the Students' Union and the academic staff in the institution. Today's festival is an opportunity to reflect on the last 10 years of teaching and learning at the university, but also to consider what future developments are likely as we continue to provide the best possible and most inspiring experience for our students. And I'm always interested in finding projects that link into the three I's that support the university, that are inspiring, that are innovative, and that are international. In fact, we've got a really interesting one going on at the moment, and it's a fantastic opportunity for our students. They get a chance to work with an international project, to work with the Duchess of York, and to work on a project that is actually going to help some people that are facing very, very difficult times in their lives. And this is a project called Key to Freedom. And in fact, we got the Duchess of York visiting the university on Tuesday to meet the students that are working on the project. And that's 10 students in the School of Art and Design. And what they're doing is looking at a range of products that some women that have been rescued from very difficult situations in India, predominantly they've been kidnapped and put into the sex trade, they've been rescued from the sex trade, and they're creating products to be manufactured and sold in top shop. And all profits go back to give them their key to freedom. I just think that's a wonderful project that captures the three I's, that inspiration, that innovation, that international. And it means that our own students get to work on a fantastic project with the Duchess of York to help people in great need. And it's projects like that that give our students that rounded experience, which really captures the inspiration that we offer at this university. There's a wonderful variety of sessions and presentations on offer today, and I hope that you'll take full advantage of them, as well as the network opportunities that they provide, and I hope that they'll also lead to new collaborations and innovations within the university. With this in mind, we should also note that this year marks the 5th anniversary of the establishment of the university's Teaching and Learning Institute. It works to disseminate and embed good practice across the university, and it has a crucial role to play in supporting and connecting colleagues to develop inspiring and innovative teaching and learning. This event sets out to accomplish exactly this. The Teaching and Learning Institute was set up by Tim Thornton as part of his role as Pro Vice Chancellor for Teaching and Learning. And as you know, Tim is about to become our new Deputy Chancellor. And I think he deserves a round of applause. So come on, Tim. Tim has been an incredible Pro Vice Chancellor for Teaching and Learning at the University, and it really has helped this institution move forward. So he's set a high bar. But what's particularly pleasing for me as Vice Chancellor is that we have the internal talent to promote into that post, and that's exactly what we've done. We've promoted Christine Jarvis to be the next Pro Vice Chancellor, Learning and Teaching. And I'm sure that Christine will make a fantastic appointment. So just to embarrass you as well, Christine, can you stand? things that symbolises and celebrates our continued excellence and ambition in teaching and learning is the fact that by some measures we are the UK's most successful university at obtaining the National Teaching Fellowships. And of course Tim's already outlined our track record there, and long may it continue. I'd like to see National Teaching Fellows in every single area in the university. Jonathan, as we heard earlier, is our latest recipient and an outstanding recipient. So Jonathan's track record is significant in terms of raising standards in student achievement, challenging discrimination and transforming students' attitudes towards inclusion. He has thus transformed the lives of many, many students and will continue to do so. So again, we offer you our congratulations, Jonathan. Fantastic achievement, and I look forward to seeing your picture outside the library at Hall of Fame. The exciting programme today features not only academic staff and support staff talking about their teaching practices, but we'll also have a number of workshops led by students, plus a keynote address from Catherine Cronin, who's visiting us from the Centre of Excellence in Learning and Teaching at the National University of Ireland in Galway. If you don't know the National University of Ireland, it is just an amazing organisation. I used to be an external examiner for them many, many years ago. And they really do set standards in being laid back. It's just incredible. There's no pressure there whatsoever. This afternoon, with Catherine, we'll explore the open world of informal and connected learning. But now I'd like to get the 10th Festival of Teaching and Learning underway by welcoming this morning's keynote speaker, although of course she requires very little introduction. Professor Janet Hargreaves, herself a National Teaching Fellow, is Associate Dean for Learning and Teaching within Human Health Sciences, and she'll be talking about our achievements and memorable moments from the last 10 years, as well as considering what challenges and opportunities lie ahead. So if you could please join me in welcoming Janet to the podium, and I wish you all a really exciting and wonderful day. Thank you very much, everyone.